Hey gang, I'm back with another video, and today this video is going to be on reviving a wig. I'm going to be watercoloring this wig and cutting it a little bit. This is a hem sew wig that I made for one of my customers. Yeah, I don't know what my customer did, but look at it. But it's not going to be anything like this when we get finished. First things first, we're going to start off with reviving the wig. And with this, I do a boiling method, so you'll need a pot. Your conditioner that you use in your weave, any type of oil, I usually use olive oil, but I don't have none, so I'm going to use my chi silk infusion. So what you want to do is fill your pot up with water first before putting your conditioner and oil in there, and let the water come to a boil. Once your water comes to a boil, you then want to add your conditioner. Then you want to add your drop of oil, just some oil to moisturize. This way is way more easier than washing your bundles because shampoo tends to stick it down. And I use tongs when I do this, and you want to mix it around. You can go ahead and turn the water off too. Then all you're going to do with the wig is take the wig and set it in the water. And just let it get saturated. Just like this. And you're going to let the wig boil. I just let it sit for a little while just to give it time. I don't know, I just like this way better than washing it. You're only using conditioner, that's all you need, and a little bit of oil. Olive oil works too, just chi oil works, or whatever oil that you like to put on your hair. To be honest, this chi is actually my favorite. And this boils all the dirt out of the hair, and you'll see that when I get ready to pour it out. You want to let it sit for a little. And when you feel like you think it's clean enough, you want to take it out. That's all. Oil and hair. When you feel that your hair has sat long enough, you then want to take it and pour it in the sink. You're going to see all the dirt. The wig to cool off a little bit before touching, but I've done it so many times and it don't bother me. But you want to rinse with cold water. And the cold water just cools it off a little for you. So that you can handle it. It may look like this, but you have to comb it out. I'm going to put some more conditioner on there, and then I'm going to detangle. We're gonna be ready to water dye you. It may look total, but it's gonna look 10 times better, I'm telling you. After applying your conditioner, you want to then detangle the hair. And the way you detangle hair is that you go from the ends to the top. And I'm starting with the back of the wig, because the neck of the wig tends to get the nappiest or tangledest, whatever you want to call it. So I'm starting right there, and then we're going from the bottom and work my magic. I'm gonna have a wide tooth comb because you don't want a lot of hair to come out. It's already getting detangled, coming out good. You want to do that until the whole entire wig, and then I will show you how. how it looks after getting detangled. As you can see, I am done detangling. I told y'all it was not gonna look bad. All I did was put conditioner on there and combed it out. And I end up using this detangling brush. Now you can comb through it. Now I'm gonna rinse the conditioner out with cold water. Then I'm gonna evap more. Put this on my mannequin stand. And I'm going to fix up the bundles a little where they had came loose or something. Basically get it back right. And I'll be back after I finish it. Okay, in the last clip, I know I said I was gonna go ahead and tighten up the tracks or whatever, but I changed my mind and I'm actually gonna wait till after I watercolor it. Y'all can't even see my face. But I went ahead and blow dried it just a little bit because I wanted the color to really take. This was my first time water drying hair, but I watched a lot of videos and I know I got it. First thing first, I want to blow dry my clothes. First thing first, I want to spray my closure with got to be spray so that the lace doesn't turn when I water dye it. So after I spray it, I then want to blow dry it. So I just sprayed it with got to be spray. And I blow dried it with hot or hot. So now I'm gonna get my boiling water and then I'm gonna let it cool off and then I'm gonna pour my dyes in there. So I went ahead and took off my shirt, a good shirt that I had on, put on the oven because you don't want to get dyed anywhere. And the dye I will be using today is by Vignette, if I'm not mistaken. It's deep burgundy and burgundy. See, this one looks a little bit more purple. It was a dark purple. I wanted to get both of them so that I can mix them together, see how it will look, and then dye the hair. So what I'm gonna do now is pour these in the water and then mix it up. So I went ahead, just going to put on my gloves, because I don't want to stain my hands any more than I have. I'm very hands on, I hate gloves, anything dealing with all the tissue in my hand. So I'm just mixing the dyes around and I'm gonna test it out. I'm about to test it out with a piece of paper towel just to see if this is the color that I'm sorry. This is the color it gave me. get that same tone that I was using for a little bit. Now I'm just gonna let it sit for like 5 more minutes. Then I'm gonna take it, rinse it with cool water and conditioning it, and then I'll be back. But yeah, I'm just continuing to flat iron it and cut the end, and then I'm going to paint curl it. I'm going to finish flat ironing it off camera, and then I'm going to come back. Okay, I'm back. I went ahead and cut it out even. That's just for me shaking it back. So if you follow the steps I did, you can do it too. But see right here where it looked like that? I'm fixing it with mascara. I'm going to show you how to fix your closures up with mascara and a concealer or foundation. And just what I do is I take my mascara and then I just swipe it with the top of it. After swiping it, then you want to take your comb and then just comb it through. This is how you fix like this. I'm gonna say like from your clothing and shin, that's how you fix it. This is Then you want to take a foundation or concealer or something. And my friend who I'm doing this for, she's kind of like a caramel tip. So I want to take this. You can use concealer or your foundation. This is a concealer thing that I have, but I have no more in there, so I just use the little brush thing because I need an angle. Or you can use the angle brush. I don't know about that right now. And then you want to drag it a line, make a line. Just be when you put on your hair. First,